start with a square. Side length, 1. We're going to choose 2 points at random on the perimeter of that square. We want the probability that those 2 points are at least 1/2 apart. My probability is going to have this form. We're not going to worry about the rest of this stuff until we find that probability. We're going to start finding that probability by drawing the square. All right, the easy part's done. We got our square. Now it starts to get tricky, because usually what we do in these probability problems, we count the number of successes, count the number of equally likely possibilities, and divide. But there are infinitely many possibilities for how we can choose 2 points, the sides of this square. So that approach isn't going to work. We're going to need something smarter. Uh-oh. I don't have anything right away, so I'm going to play with the problem. I'm just going to imagine I pick the first point here. What can happen to the second point? Well, one thing that can happen to the second point is going to end up on the opposite side. And I like thinking about that because it's easy to think about that. Any point on the opposite side is at least 1 away from our first point, and 1 is greater than 1/2. Watch these videos for keen insights like that. Because 1 is greater than 1/2, any point that ends up on this side is going to be at least 1/2 away from this point, and we're going to win. So anytime we end up on opposite sides, we win. The points are at least 1/2 apart. Now, how often does that happen? Now, no matter what side we pick this first point on, the probability that the second point is going to be on the opposite side is just 1/4. Because the second point is equally likely to end up on any one of the 4 sides. There's only 1 opposite side. So 1/4 of the time, the 2 points will end up on opposite sides, and then they're guaranteed to be at least 1/2 apart. Now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, what about the corners? How many corners there are here? There are 4 corners. You know how many possibilities there are for where we could choose a point? Infinitely many! So we know about how often we're going to pick a corner. So we're not going to worry about the corners. Anytime we pick a point on any one given side, probability, get a point on the opposite side, 1/4. Not worrying about the corners, but we do have a good idea of what our other cases are. We've got same side, and we've got adjacent side. Now, the probability the 2 points end up on the same side is, again, 1/4, because once we've chosen the first point, there's 1 of the 4 sides where the second point can land. They'll be on the same side. And the adjacent side, well, that leaves 1/2. It'll land on land on one of these 2 sides 1/2 the time. But these cases are harder, because we don't always win, don't always lose on these 2 sides. Always win when we end up opposite sides, but these are different. So I'm going to tackle the same side first and draw another picture. So here's our square again. And we're going to imagine the 2 points end up over here. And what's the probability they're at least 1/2 apart? Again, we have this issue of, well, if we try to count the successes, divide by the number of possibilities, number of successes, they're both still infinitely many, so I can't use that strategy. So we're going to have to use something that's good at measuring infinite sets. Geometry's good at that. Geometry gives us good tools, length, area, for measuring infinite sets of things. So we're going to use geometry here. Now, where are we going to do that? We're going to say that this point here is x. I'm going to call that point A. And point B is y from the bottom. And clearly, x and y, they can be anything from 0 to 1. Arrange these points up and down the side. And I'm going to draw a picture of what x and y can be. Now, this picture, not the same square as this, this is a picture of our values of x on this axis, of course, and y on this one. And we're going to map. We're going to draw a little picture here of all the possibilities of x and y. Because this is all right here, this unit square right here, all the possibilities for x and y. So that's our possible space. And its measure is its area is 1. And then we're going to draw a picture of the successes when x and y are at least 1/2 apart. So now let's imagine x is 0. Then y has to be greater than or equal to 1/2. Y can be anything from 1/2 up. That's a win. Now imagine x is 1/4. Then y can be anything from 3/4 up. That's a win. You know, x is 1/8. Y can be anything from 5/8 up. And you can kind of see what's going on here. As we increase x from 0 all the way up to, say, 1/2, that minimum possible value for y goes from 1/2 all the way up to 1. And as long as y is above this line, We're good. The distance between x and y is at least a half. Then when x equals hits a half and goes higher, well, then none of these high values of y work anymore, but low values work now. As x goes from 1 half up to 1, well, the maximum value for y goes from 0 up to a half. You start to climb. Anything down here works now. So you have x is 3 quarters and y is 1 eighth. You know, that's right in here somewhere. That's good. So these are the successful regions. And so the area of this region, that's the measure of our success. So the area of the possibilities is 1. The area of the success is, well, if we push these two triangles together, we'll get this little square that's a quarter of the large square. Side length is a half, area is a quarter. So the probability that we succeed here, area of the successful region divided by the area of the possible region, that's a quarter. So now we know that when we land on the same side, that happens a quarter of the time. And each time the two points are on the same side, we succeed a quarter of the time. So the probability that we get success in this case, total probability that we end up on the same side and they end up at least a half apart, is 1/16. So we've taken care of same side, we've taken care of opposite side. Now we're going to talk about adjacent side. And you know the game. Now we're going to draw a picture, use some geometry. So here's our original square. And we're going to put one point down here, and we're going to say that that's x away. We're going to put one point up here. We're going to say that that's y away. And we're going to draw our picture of what x and y can be. X and y each can range from 0 to 1. That's x, this is y, and there's our picture of our possible regions. But what are our successes? We want the distance between these two to be at least a half. Well, the distance between these two, you can use the Pythagorean theorem, x squared plus y squared has to be at least 1 half squared. What's that look like? We know what it looks like if we replace this with an equal sign, right? If you drop an equal sign right there, we're talking about a circle over here. We're talking about a circle with radius 1 half. We're talking about this circle right here. Center at the origin, radius 1 half. That's what it looks like when the sum of these squares is equal to 1 half. But if it's going to be, the sum of these squares is equal to 1 half squared, that is. If it's going to be greater than 1 half squared, well, that's going to be out here. When the sum of these squares equals 1 half squared, we get our circle with radius 1 half. When it's greater, that means we're going outside that circle. If we're going to be less than that, we're going to be inside the circle. So here is our success. There's all this stuff out here. And you kind of sanity check this. What happens when x and y are both large? Well, then the points are out here. They're more than a half apart. So now we need to find the area of this region right here. That's going to give us our success because our possible region has area 1. Well, this is just the whole square, which is 1, minus the area of this quarter circle. Well, the circle has radius 1 half, so a whole circle would be pi over 4. You only want a quarter of it. It's pi over 16. And that's the probability these two end up at least a half apart if they're on the same side. So let's bring this back to our first page right here. Half the time, they end up on adjacent sides, and of that half the time, 1 minus pi over 16 of the time, so we end up at least 1 half apart. So our total contribution to our total probability of the cases where the points are on adjacent sides, we multiply this out, we get 1 half minus pi over 32. So now our total probability is what we get when we add up all three of these cases. Our denominator is going to be 16 here. It's going to be 32. We've got 2 30 seconds there. 8 30 seconds there, that gives us 10, there's 16 more. We got 26 30 seconds minus pi in the numerator. So now I've got it in this form. A is 26, B is 1, and C is 32. 26 plus 1 plus 32 gives us 59. A plus B plus C is 59, and we're done.